Hello everyone, welcome to Black Arrow Gaming. I'm Bob, and this is the 12th episode in our Age of Wonders 3 co-op strategy challenge. In this series, I've been playing with Evan. We were taking on 6 Emperor computers, have whittled it down to 3, only 3 left, but the 3 that are left have become insanely powerful, especially the Dreadnought and the Goblin southwest and to the west over here in this area. Those two are crazy strong. Orange is pretty tough, too. They have a lot of tanks, a lot of juggernauts. Evan and I, in the last episode, we lost some territory here in the south center portion of the map and had to fall back. In fact, we both lost fairly significant armies down there. And at this point, it's basically come down to we need to hold Engranost and this other city here, Anthoria, at all costs. These cities are acting like a buffer zone between the enemies here and our core cities up in this area. These cities cannot fall, particularly in my case, Muldan, and obviously Dunedel being my capital city. Those two are incredibly important. We're definitely on defense right now. There's a lot of armies heading this way. The return of Evan's main king's army to the mainland to help defend will be a big help, but we're still going to need a lot more firepower down here. So, with that all in mind, I kind of want to take a look at what I'm currently doing with my units. I want to get units onto the front line that are going to be able to help with Manticore Riders, because those seem to be the biggest immediate threat. And Griffin Riders would help some. The higher resistance should help them resist the stunning, inflict stun ability. But Griffin Riders otherwise are just like a way less powerful version of a Manticore Rider. So those aren't really a good long-term solution. What I want to do is mass-produce Storm Sisters and hopefully start stunning stuff. They're also a unit that can defend walls pretty well. In the meantime, in my capital city, I'm going to cancel the production of merchandise, and I'm going to try to build more archers, at least a handful more, and try to get them down into Engranost. They aren't really a good answer for Manticore Riders, but they would at least help. Since there's no other units in the immediate area around my capital, I'm going to send all the units that are in it out. There hasn't really been anything threatening it for a while now, so I'm going to go ahead and abandon the capital and just try to get units to the front line as soon as I can. It wasn't like the capital had enough defense in it to stop any significant attack anyway. I'll probably leave a couple of these archers that I'm building now in there, but I want to get these other ones to the front line soon. I have a number of notifications I want to go through. I did meet hostile dragons out here. Don't really care about them. Should probably just cast Undead Plague on them, to be honest. I wonder if I can do that on this turn. I can't do that on this turn, because I need 60 casting points. And it takes, and I only have 43, so that's all right. Instead, I am going to actually cast Scales of Fortune on my capital city, or maybe I should cast the strategic spell. I kind of want to get Shield of Dispassion up. That would give all my units an extra resistance, and that could mean the difference of life or death against Manticore Riders with Inflict Stun. Of course, they'll probably just disjunct it fairly quickly, but I think I'm going to at least try. I feel like that would help more right now than anything else would. Fortunately, the Draconians had a critical failure when trying to disjunct Undead Plague, so that helps. I met some goblins underground that wanted peace, but there's not much I can do with them right now. And of course, that's the city I lost on the last turn. In good news, this orc city out here has just grown to a metropolis size, so that's about as big as it's going to get. I'm probably just going to keep making shock troopers here as often as I can, despite the fact that they won't be that useful against the Manticore Riders. They still may come in handy against the Dreadnought. They do a lot of up-close damage, so I'm going to have that city produce at least one more, maybe two. And I might actually send a couple of those units out here. You know what I actually might want to do is get a builder out there somewhere. I have cleared out some structures in this area. Maybe at least a fort. Nah, I need military for now, so I'm going to let it finish the shock trooper that it's building. This city here, since the dreadnought pulled away, I can afford to send some of my units to the front line. I don't want to leave myself spread too thin down here, but I don't think anything's threatening this underground city at the moment. I want to take this group and get them to the front line as soon as I can, and should probably send some of these units along with them. Maybe an archer and a storm sister to kind of join up with those units here. And the other storm sisters that I'm sending in that direction. Also should probably get a reanimator out there too to help with healing, because that army doesn't really have any of it. Otherwise, I think they're good. And the dragons have a quest for me. They want me to raise a city to the ground. That's the goblin city I just made friends with. Befriending the dragons would be very nice, but to be honest, they're not even offering me vassal right now. It costs a lot of money, it's kind of a long ways away, and it's an impossible city to defend from the goblins, assuming they're underground. So I'm going to decline that quest, I think. Oh man, that's a tough call though, because dragons would really help. It's just I have no way to hold that city, especially because you can't build walls in it. Let me look at the army that I've got down here. No, I think we need to stick to the plan. Armies have to stay where they're at and hold the front line for now. I can't afford to spread out and give the enemy an opening into our territory. Alright, so that kind of wraps up leftovers from last turn. And we'll go ahead and head into the next one here. I don't think there's anything I need to move quickly. I don't know. I don't know if there's Manticore Riders in this fog of war down here, so I should probably get my King's Army next to Engranost to kind of hold that border a little better. So I'll do that. Whoops. Why did it flip me over here? Okay, my army auto-moved onto that tile and just wasted some movement. Oh well. Okay. We'll try ending the turn again. Here we go. Okay, just in case Evan needs to pull more units over here, I'll leave that road spot open for him. Kind of get the Storm Sisters over here to form a triangle and bring more units in. Evan is going to add some units to this group. And I'll bring more from the west. Oh gosh. I'm probably going to get wrecked again. The dreadnought just... Oh, it was the army he just took the halfling city with. He's going to come careening through the underground. I did not see this group coming. I didn't think they could get here on this turn. I thought I'd take them one more. Alright, well, just got to try the best to do something with this group, I guess. Can stiffen limbs on a few things. I think it might almost be better to fall back and let the juggernauts come onto the wall while they're busy blowing their way through it. Well, no, they don't really have a whole lot of flying units that would fly over it, just the fairy and the eagle. To see what sort of spells this theocrat can cast that might be helpful. Well, rebirth probably isn't going to help because I'm probably not going to win this battle. Slayer's Doubt would be nice if I could get it to work on a majority of their other units, or maybe even their hero. I'm going to try that. Try at least giving their hero Slayer's Doubt. And I do need to pay attention to how many casting points he has. He has 25, which means he can cast Slayer's Doubt 3 times. Okay. That'll slow their hero down, keep him a bit further away from me. The cadaver is going to probably go here, just to get in the way. And I'm going to actually slide some of my units. I shouldn't have moved the cadaver there. Oh, no, wait, he can go through the gate. I'm going to slide some of my units kind of this way to get them away from the juggernauts as much as I can. It might not make a difference, but I'd rather have them not all get blasted by the two juggernauts on the left or on the right side if it can be avoided. I'm just going to have to hope to take down as many of them with me as I can during this battle. I should have pulled this army back and just let them have that city there. Kind of out and exposed a bit more than I'd prefer. I have no good answer for those dreadnoughts, other than not bunching my units up. And keeping the reanimators in the back is probably going to be a better solution to this problem, because many of their units resist the type of damage they do, with the exception of those sun guards back there, but they're not really a threat just yet. I'm going to keep these units back, hopefully let the juggernauts do their opening mortar volley, and do as little damage as possible to the units in the area. If I spread them out well enough, I think it'll be okay. My king is, or my hero will just continue to cast Slayer's Doubt on whatever he can. At the very least, he has electrical magic, and that could help against those juggernauts, but I want them to let their guard down first. I'm going to put Slayer's Doubt on the eagle, because that's one of the things that can cross the wall like now. So I'm going to slow that down and hopefully make it less of an issue. And I'll have the knight up front on defense, because if anything's going to get hit by those tanks, he's the one that I'd prefer get hit. He's got a lot of defense. Okay, they're just going to try to blow their way through, which is about as good as I could have hoped for. Wow, that cadaver took those hits like a champion. Okay, they just unloaded everything they had on my knight, which is probably good for me. I didn't lose any units right there. And their dreadnoughts are going to be reloading for a couple of turns, which may give me an opportunity to strike back. I want to heal the knight for as much as I can. I'm not quite ready to charge him out there yet and go after those juggernauts. I want their other units to hopefully come in first. I'll leave the cadavers on defense just so something has to hit them. And I'll focus my healing on that knight. I think all their units used their fire mortar. Yeah, they did. Okay, so having this little group bunched up back here hopefully won't be a big problem. And then I would like to cast Slayer's Doubt on something again. Yeah, I'm going to. I'll cast Slayer's Doubt on something this turn, and then have my king, or have my hero, be able to run up on the wall and use Shock Bolts on the next turn. So just get one more thing debuffed. Probably the Boar Rider, since it's a cavalry unit. And I want to get the bear down here, kind of closer to the entrance. I'm thinking about having it rush out and go after something. I'm going to get it just far enough away, though, so that if one of those things uses its broadside on the cadaver, it won't kill the bear or hurt the bear, too. No, they're just going to come running right up. Oh, the cadaver hangs in for another hit. Look at that. Okay, they're getting pretty aggressive with this juggernaut over here. It doesn't have any ability to hit me if I move, so backing up and shooting it with shock magic's a pretty easy decision. I can try to take out at least that. The eagle is not even going to be able to make it over the wall, so I don't have to worry about my king getting, or my hero getting flanked. I'd say that the obvious best choice in this situation is to try to take that juggernaut out. Webbing it is only a 35% chance to work, and I don't want to waste an opportunity to hit this thing. If I can turn it around, though, for a little extra damage, I probably should. That cadaver is just awesome, holding off that boar rider like it has. And I'm thinking that if I can use it to siphon a little bit more movement away from it, it might be okay to use my bear to flank that juggernaut. Get a couple good hits in on it. In fact, I think that's going to be a good idea regardless of what happens. That gives me three nice flank hits in the back, which takes its health down to about half. And I'm going to go ahead and try to eat up some of his movement. Okay, I left him with a bit more than I'd like, but... Oh, they must have dispelled... Oh wait, that's a sun guard, not a boar rider. Staying the wrong thing. And then I guess the rest of this is just going to be up to the knights to get in there and hit the thing. I'd really like to kill it on this turn. I need to get this griffin rider in here too. But I don't know if I'm going to be able to. Let's see if I can get that devastating charge built up. A couple really powerful hits. I think I can get it. Maybe with the reanimators I can finish it off. I think they're the only two units that have movement left. Yep. Yeah, they should be able to. There we go. That prevents that from using its broadside, at least. This other reanimator is going to be best off shooting at the Tigran Sun Guard, probably to just despair it or something. That does a fairly good amount of damage to a Sun Guard, too, and gave it some debuffs that could be helpful when dealing with that bear. Oh, man. Well, there goes half my army. Now it becomes a game of kill as many things as I can. They gave that overload, which I think lets it fire again right away. No, that's not what it is. To be honest, I'm not sure how it fired again so quickly. I guess maybe two turns have passed. Oh well, there's not a whole lot I could have done about it anyway. At least I took out one of these things. Now to decide what the best way of doing the most amount of damage possible is at this point. I would like to get out there and kill their hero if I could, but I don't think that's going to be an option. I could use healing essence. Use Death Ray. Stiffen Limbs isn't very useful here. Death Ray wouldn't do much damage to that hero. One, two, three. You could get a couple good flank attacks on that. And I'm going to try to take out one more Juggernaut. It's probably a mistake, but... Okay, the critical hit definitely helps. Get another flank. And probably should cast Death Ray. It won't make much of a difference. I'll cast it on something else that I can actually kill with it. Cast it on this guy. Oh gosh. Oh man. That's not good. I didn't think they'd get down here that fast. Okay, well, I can at least back that Griffin Rider off before they kill that too. At least I took out one of their juggernauts. Oh my gosh, though, if that army cruises north here and through the underground, that's going to be a problem. Although by then I will have four Storm Sisters that I can get down here, and that will help significantly with the juggernauts, especially if I can get them leveled up a bit. They're a little fragile, though, so have to be careful there. Okay, for this one, that Rake's Governance upgrade, I need to check to see how many gold mines I have in my Dwarven City up here. Only one. It'd be like an extra one gold, or an extra three gold per turn. I'd rather have the bonus for Axemen and Deep Guards, because that would benefit this army quite a bit. So, that's what I will do. That gets them plus two melee strength, so I'll take that. Okay. I had a slight change of plans. Given the units we're facing, I really want Chthonic Guardians in. The Deathbringers would be nice, but they're not. I have more faith in getting at least if I could get a few tier 4 units onto the battlefield. To get them, I want to research strategic spells, and I should probably research whichever ones I can research fastest just to try to get that to pop up. So I'll research this one I can get in one turn here that I'll probably never use. Okay, I got another Shock Trooper here. With the amount of Dreadnought units closing in on my front line, I want to get some really tough units down there to kind of help hopefully stave them off. Something to kind of give the Storm Sisters a little bit of protection. So I'm going to send these guys down in that direction. That other Dragon Army that showed up over here a while ago, I haven't seen them in a while. So I think it'll be okay to send these guys away and just keep building more up there. Having units on the front line right now is really the most important thing I could do. Evan's continuing to clear out some structures underground, kind of moving this army to the west, I think, to see what's through that path over there. Back over here is where I'm trying to get my elf city built, and Evan's army is on their way out. I don't think his army can pass through mine, so I may have to dig a way for them to get around each other here. In fact, I'm going to dig a few different routes around this area. That's rock cavern walls. Can't go that way. It's all rock cavern walls. So I'm a little blocked off there, but that's okay. Alright, with this newly slightly beefed up army a little bit, I can go after some other things in this area. Having those extra casting points might be kind of handy, so I think I'll grab those. Might help me get Shield of Dispassion one turn earlier. In fact, it would. Yeah, it might. It might help me get it on this turn here. These units are resistant to physical damage, but with this many against them, plus a reanimator in the mix, should be fine. I should be able to get him to charge the Dreadnought and then just counterattack. Or, not the Dreadnought, the Deep Guard. Okay. Get this other Deep Guard right up in his face. They do a decent amount of shock damage to him. I can soften him up a bit with defensive strike from an axeman, though. and they're just about out of movement. You can't kill this many dwarves. Alright, let's see if that gives me enough to cast Shield of Dispassion on this turn, and it does. Well, that'll at least give them something to disjunct. So this will give all of my units plus one resistance unless flanked, and all my dedicated and neutral units will get an additional plus two unless flanked. Now that I'm actually making some dedicated and neutral units now, that could be helpful. Alright, kind of would like to go after this structure here, but I don't know that there's a huge benefit to me, and it's kind of an evenly balanced battle. I'd probably lose some units. I'd rather use this army to continue clearing structures, picking up resources, and killing anything that spawns mobs out here. So the way that I've... Oh, never mind. Heaven's Navy just took out another straggler on the water on their way up. They desperately need healing. It's kind of surprising to me that the Manticore Riders haven't gone after them yet. Heaven's kind of in a race back towards... Ew. It's not going to be an easy battle. In Nipuk. He's bringing in some reinforcements at least. Hopefully he can get there before the bulk of their army can attack it. At least the Theocrat's army isn't all flying units or anything like that. Should buy him an extra turn at least. If I get a few more units down near Engranost, do you think it would be worth going after the Dreadnought if it seems that the bulk of their army is going towards your northern cities?
Bulk of whose army?
Well, actually, now that I'm looking at it, I only see a couple brown units. So they're still flying around there over the bay somewhere. So yeah, now's probably not a good time to leave. It's mostly teal going north after you, I suppose. Alright, given what I've seen underground, I'm going to need some backup down there, assuming the Dreadnought comes that way. Evan and I already have quite a few units in Engranost that should be able to hold off a medium-size attack. I want to get at least two full stacks out there, so I'll continue out with this group, because they have a reanimator anyway, and give them an archer too, for a little extra range. But otherwise... I need to brace a little bit for that Dreadnought coming in through the underground, so I'm going to pull one Storm Sister back, send two of them underground on this turn. I'll give those units lucky since they're in the area, and since I have time. I really have to get some electricity magic down there to deal with that Dreadnought, or he's just going to keep blowing everything away with those tanks. In the meantime, I'm really not sure what I want this army here to do. I'll move them here for now, but that's kind of a tough call. Oh, I probably should build a road through this area. Would help me defend both Engranost and get underground kind of quickly. Although I can't really spare the resources for a builder even right now. Alright, I'm just going to have them wait for the moment. Looking at what I've got in that city, I think I'll be okay. I am going to give this hero her own army. And I probably should mix my Storm Sisters and Archers up just a little bit. I'll get it on the next turn when they have more movement. Can't cast Undead Plague on anything, but I can get a bit closer to Brown Cities. Hopefully cause some trouble behind things. Kind of where Evan's Cherub's going to. And I'm hoping this lost soul can spot something good down here. There's some goblin units over there. Maybe I can sneak away from them. Alright, and then these guys... You know, I probably should still send these ones out. They don't look like they'd be particularly helpful against a dreadnought. Maybe a little more so against a warlord. It's probably where the archers should be going, because they should still do decent damage to manticore riders. I only need a few of them against the army with the dreadnought, I think. Alright. Keep the city producing those shock troopers. And keep my king's army where it is for the moment. Hopefully that braces us pretty well for any attack that might show up on this turn. Things I need to do quickly next turn. Probably just moving these armies all in one bunch and getting my lost soul out of the underground where it's a little vulnerable right now. Evan has a couple moves he needs to make quickly on this turn too, so we'll have to be fast. And put the archer with the king. Actually, should put another Storm Sister with the king to mix them up a bit more. There we go. That's a fairly nice balance of units in each of those two stacks. I'll put them on defense and just have them camp here for a while. If the dreadnought comes north, that'd be really nice. I would actually really like that because we have an army there now that could probably kick its butt. Underground, I did have a scout that I wanted to move. Oh, the goblins just ran right past him. But as you can see, they are sending armies east. Oh, I don't need that notification. Now that I've lost pretty much everything underground except for this city is going to be the big holding point to keep units from crossing out. In fact, I might actually almost want to make a fort right there at that cave entrance so I have a defensive structure to pile units on, and I could prevent anything from going out without fighting its way through that fort. That might be a good idea. I would have to sacrifice that Tigran city there, which would be a shame, but it's something worth considering. If nothing else, I'll let it finish building that observatory, and then I'll send my builder back that direction to probably do that. I'll get my settler out of Evan's way with this army down here. And I'm gonna send my builder back now. Whispers of the Fallen is another strategic spell that I can get in one turn. Again, not very useful, but if it gets me closer to summon Chthonic Guardian, I'm okay with it. That should be one of the next Greyguard spells that I have coming up here. After that, I'm going to have to buff my casting points a lot. Some wandering animals took a structure. I wanted to kill them on this turn, but didn't get a chance. Alright, next priority is to reinforce this city down here. I'm gonna have to send at least a full second army down there, possibly a third one. Because if stuff starts popping up near Mul'dan, I'm gonna be in trouble. I'm going to get these units, these elf units, kind of out in this direction towards where the center of all this fighting is, seems like it's going to be. It'd be nice to just have them as backup for a different city that needs them. I wish I could combine them with one of Evan's stacks, but unfortunately that is not something that you can do in this game. And then I'll be sending these lost, or these Storm Sisters underground pretty much every turn now, going forward. The nice thing is I can build these in one turn, I can make them very fast. And the fact that they're silver rank is very nice. If I can just get them some experience to where I can start stunning things, that should kind of start stacking the odds in my favor fairly quickly, because the more that can stun, the easier it is for other ones to get more XP by killing the ones that are already, the enemies that are already stunned. I think for the moment, this Druid's army is going to do better in a battle against units out here. So I'm probably going to actually combine my Druid's army, because the Druid isn't that useful against a Dreadnought, unless I think there's a certain spell that can rot a machine, but I don't think he has that yet. He could probably get it, though. Evan just hit Teal with a preemptive strike out here. Had to deal with some irritating stun, which seems to be becoming a habit. But did knock out a decent number of Teal's units, which helps. If they're going to keep splitting their army into smaller groups, hey, that's their actual army, that's their actual leader charging up the hill, or up the road towards Nippuck. Not like we could really launch a good counterattack. As nice as that would be, we don't even know where their capital is. Evan marked these units as a heretic. That's two Manticore Riders, so that's kind of nice. And they seem to be running... right
after Anthoria.
Yeah. Which is probably good. Do you need me to bring units up to help?
I'm pulling my army back.
Okay, then I'll leave the bulk of my forces down closer to Ugluck or Engranost. Alright, back what I was debating over here is what to do with this Druid. And I think that because he's kind of close to leveling up, and because there isn't really any other heroes with these units that are going underground, I am going to have him stay with them. I'll send a couple of units off. Probably should send this reanimator out to join these other elf units, just to make a secondary army out here. Kind of desperately need reanimators. But I think I've got a couple underground. I want to keep the Griffin Rider with this group. Well, you know what? The Griffin Rider could probably go out here with them too. It might have a better chance of resisting the stun of those Griffin Riders wherever they show up. So then it'll be these units going back to the underground. Let's see. I have 5. I may as well throw in an extra swordsman, make it 6. There we go. Alright, and then they'll go back underground. I want to keep at least one archer and one griffin rider in that city, because there were some animals running around out there, and I don't want to take the chance of losing it because of a stupid mistake. Alright, so here come reinforcements. I think I might position the Griffin Rider with that other army. Just depending on how my field of vision is, I want to make sure I can see that cave exit at all times. Just one Frostling Queen coming through here, but there may have been some other Goblin units running east along that road that I saw earlier, so probably shouldn't assume that's all that there is. I'm just going to have to try to hold that cave entrance as best as I can. That's probably where they're headed, is the only city that I have left down here. Well, this is kind of convenient for my Lost Soul, a path I can go through to get onto some lava out here, hopefully keep exploring. Okay. Just gotta get those shock troopers onto the front line, so keep bringing them down. And camp with those units there. And I'll send one more archer out towards the front lines, because I'm sure I'm going to need them somewhere, but I'll build a few more. The rest of them that I build in that city probably need to stay there. Okay, on the next turn I should be able to get up and cast Undead Plague on what might possibly be... No, that's not Brown's capital city. Not sure where their capital is exactly. We apparently haven't found it yet. Alright, and that's pretty much everything. Nothing I need to move quickly on this next turn, except for maybe that goblin underground. And no units showing their faces around Engranost yet. Gonna give Evan a chance to move first in case there's anything he needs to do, so I'll wait a second. Evan got a preemptive strike out here. There's a number of other things he's going to be attacking really quickly here. Another preemptive strike took out an exalted and a couple Zephyr Birds so far in this turn. We'll see what else he can hit before the computers start making their moves. All things considered, he's done a pretty good job of kind of keeping things, you know, taking out small groups of units wherever he can. And then yet,
actually,
Evan was able to run his scout away from a halfling pony rider embarked on the water. Without advanced seafaring, it couldn't catch up to his cherub, so he just ran away until the battle ended. Received a proposal from the fairies underground. These people are a little bit closer to me, and in a little area that would be a little bit easier for us to defend, I think. That might be a good idea for me to do. I'm going to check my morale or my neutrality. Right now I'm perfectly neutral. I'll go ahead and actually accept peace with them. Some nightshade fairies might be kind of nice, if I can get them. And I'll let them know when they're ready to talk. I like the position of where that city is much better than where the dragon city is sticking way out here. Okay, still no summon Jathanic Guardian. I'll get Resurrect Hero, because that's probably a useful spell to have anyway. My king can get some upgrades. Obviously, right now, I want to pick things that are going to help with those Manticore Riders, anything. I don't know if the Necromancer has anything necessarily that would. Evan took out another Manticore Rider that was straggling by itself. Anytime we can get one of those, that's a big win for us.
Yeah, I think my plan at this point is just make a bunch of exalteds and fly them around taking out stragglers.
That's probably a good plan considering the geography of your territory. There's rivers everywhere. Being able to cross right over them is going to give you an advantage over any units that come in on land, and hopefully they'll bunch their Manticore Riders with other land units that are going to slow them down. They haven't seemed to be doing that so far though, so I don't know if I'd count on that. Alright, I'm going to leave, like I was saying, I'm going to leave the longbowmen that are producing in that city in my capital for now then, just to ward off a scout if something shows up. Trying to decide where to put all these orc shock troopers that I made. I want at least two Storm Sisters in each of those cities in case the Dreadnought shows up with an army. Oh hey, speaking of the Dreadnought, he is coming right through, or walking right past Engranost going towards Mul'dan. With at least one army. I wonder if my Storm Sisters can make it that far on this turn. Not quite. But if that army moves up any further, they should walk into a fairly decent trap up here. I just sent some Storm Sisters underground, but I think I'm going to pull them back up for a moment to deal with this. Yeah. Kind of a tough call, but I want to look around. I don't see anything. I should see orange coming a long ways in advance thanks to this watchtower that I have underground. And I don't see any orange or teal units. Although teal is more likely to come from this direction if they approach me from underground. Still, I think I'd be okay with sending this Storm Sister back up. Probably as well as a couple other units. I'll have this one hit the haste berries to join up with the others a little quicker. Send her up along with her. Since the Dreadnought isn't in this area right now, I don't desperately need Storm Sisters down here, but I will leave my Theocrat and the other archers down here. The archers wouldn't be that useful against the Juggernauts anyway. Have them join this Storm Sister. Get over here. Might actually run them down through there on the next turn. Oh, I should have positioned them a little differently, and I could have hit the haste berries. That's okay. This army, I'm going to have to kind of pull them back. They're going to have to get split up, because I can't afford to let this army fight an army of weaker units and just wipe them all out. So instead, I'm going to send these guys out here to just be kind of backup units wherever they're needed, whether they need to go to Anthoria or go down to Engranost. They should be able to get anywhere in one, pretty much one turn. Well, not quite. I need to reposition them a little bit, but they'll get there. The Griffin Rider could probably catch up with them, but I think I'm going to leave it back here to help lead the charge against these Dreadnoughts, since I am going to want a couple tougher units in this battle anyway. Hopefully the Orcs can make it down. Yeah, the Orcs can get involved in this battle too. That ought to be fun. So I would say the three Orcs, honestly the three Orcs and the three Storm Sisters might be able to do it, but I'll try to get a bigger group. Whoops, I didn't need to hit those haste berries. Actually, that's good, because it prevents them from hitting the haste berries. So that does help me a little bit. And I'll pile all these units up on top of each other for now. Probably pulling them back just slightly in this direction. Come on, everyone. There we go. And yeah, I think that looks pretty good. Get this Storm Sister out a little closer to the battle, and they should be okay there. If they do get attacked, I'll have numbers. It wouldn't be a battle I'd really want to fight. I'd probably lose stuff, but I don't think the enemy can reach them there. Hoping the Dreadnought sees what he's up against and tries to turn tail and run, but I think I'll be able to chase him down. Alright, back to this city. This city is one that I'm questioning now whether or not I'm going to be able to hold it. So what I think I'm going to do with that builder is build another watchtower in this direction to keep an eye out for goblins, and then build a fort right outside of this cave exit here. And if things look bad, I will pull my army back to defend the fort instead of this city. That way they don't run units right past me. It is a bit of a sacrifice because I do have another city that I'm going to be building down here. But I don't know if they know that city's out there, and it's kind of out of the way for them to go after anyway. If you want to move your units up a little bit more underground, you can. I moved my builder. Yeah. So, for now, I'm going to build merchandise in this city, I think. In fact, Seek Knowledge might be even better. It doesn't give me a lot of difference, though. This gives me 35 more gold, so I'm going to say produce merchandise indefinitely. Since I'm producing units pretty much everywhere right now, as fast as I can, I need all the gold I can get. As nice as research would be. Get a few more shock troopers out. I'm not sure what my dwarf army is looking for at this point. Just anything that spawns monsters. I don't see anything, but I suspect there's another haunted boneyard in this area somewhere. I'll have them get those haste berries, and then I'll look around a little more through this road, since I've never actually been through here. It's the heart of the blight, so that's not an issue right now. It's just that Naga city, as far as I can tell. I can cast Undead Plague on Brown this turn, and I think I should probably go ahead and do that. If nothing else, just to slow him down.
You notice I found Brown's throne down there?
Where is that at?
Other city.
Yeah. Oh, yep, I see it. That's it right there. Yeah, that's... trying to think. I mean, it's not really in a position we could hit, but... Oh no, stop. No, no auto movement. Stop. It's not really in a position we could hit, unfortunately, but it's good to know at least where it is. Unfortunately, we have a bay full of Manticore Riders to cross before we can get there. Alright, this seems like the most reasonable spot to put this city. So I'll build that up right away. In this city, as soon as I can get it kind of archer ready, I'll cast Scales of Fortune on it to make them a little bit better. Hopefully do critical damage a little more often. That's actually something I probably should have cast on my capital a while ago, considering all the archers it's producing, but that's alright. I've been spending my mana elsewhere too. Alright, I'll get this lost soul onto this lava river. These are usually a good way to find things underground, is having a floating or flying unit running around on these. Many other units can't traverse that terrain. Ugh. I don't like just sitting here waiting for those Manticore Riders to show up. I can get one more archer with this group. Every little bit helps. Alright, here we go. Hopefully that dreadnought comes this way. I'm gonna wait and see what they do. Evan got another battle in, killed some more goblin units, and continues to march down to kill their main leader. Okay, Evan's army is doing some work out here. He got Kill the Goblin's leader, which will prevent them from casting any global or any other spells for a few turns. Looks like it may have even scared some of their units into retreating. Very helpful for us.
They could have just killed all their units.
Evan continues to slaughter these poor helpless goblin stragglers, and here goes another one.
Stop combat.
Yeah. Good. That's a lot of dead goblins over the past few turns. Just don't want to let our guard down, of course, but hey, another hero option. This one being a dreadnought. Can you think of a dreadnought hero being particularly useful to us at this point? Any abilities it has that would be helpful? Or should I pass and go for something else?
I don't know. It depends on what your units are and what your other heroes are. I actually got a dreadnought too.
Almost can't even afford another hero right now with how many units I'm producing. I mean, I could, but I don't know if I really want to. I think I'm gonna say I require another type of hero, and I'm just gonna try to hope I get lucky and get another necromancer. Hey, an item finally arrived. Okay, Orange did walk right into the middle of all of my units out here, so I can launch a counterattack. Hopefully this will be an opportunity for me to get a few Storm Sisters promoted, which should be insanely helpful. I'm going to split my army up a little bit, a couple more powerful units over here, a couple more down here, All right, Storm Sisters act like reanimators now with Heal Undead. I'd forgotten about that. Which makes the reanimators a little less important. In fact, almost not needed. Other than for raising cadavers, if I want to do that. Okay, get as many of these guys in the fight as I can. That makes 5 in that group. And another one here. And one archer for each group. That should be a pretty good balance. I have overwhelming force, should be able to win this battle pretty easily. And then move on from there. Yeah, very likely victory. Unfortunately, going up against a juggernaut, even with one of those tanks, there's a good chance I'm going to lose something. It's just annoying. It's kind of the way it is. Fortunately, I do have at least the one reanimator that could bring somebody back to life, including a Storm Sister, so I guess that's one good reason to keep reanimators around. This thing is running right at this army down here that doesn't have any Storm Sisters. I'm going to actually kind of move everyone, but leave them on defense. Maybe spread them out in a little bit bizarrely, so that I can try to get some flank attacks. And I think that that's probably the best position to have everything in here. I'd probably kill the boar before it even hits anything with this group. Every little bit of XP helps in this situation, so that's fine with me. And that Yeti can't quite hit anything yet. I'm going to try to goad it into going after the Griffin Rider and letting its guard down. This other shock trooper I'll pull over here to help deal with that juggernaut if I need to. Kind of leave more of the defensive units towards the front. And get the archer up here to maybe deal with the Yeti. Any spells I can cast that would be helpful? I don't know that there really are, but maybe stiffen limbs on their hero. Probably not a bad decision. Okay, magic fist. There's his cannon. They haven't killed anything yet, and they left their machine pretty vulnerable. Although, unfortunately, I don't have any enough Storm Sisters in the area to deal with it. They're kind of off somewhere else, which is a bit of a problem. I want to try to get this thing to turn around so I can flank it. Because their hero has stiffened limbs, I don't have to worry about it flanking me, so I'm going to take the Griffin Rider out there and turn it around. Well, of course, I can't flank it. It's on defense. Oh, that was a dumb mistake. Anyway, I have enough range units here that I can just kind of light it up with everything that I've got. Get my Storm Sisters a bunch of experience. And finish it off with... Well, actually, I don't need to finish it off with anything. With that Griffin Rider being right there, I guess their hero could turn it around and then it could flank the Griffin Rider. Yeah, I don't want that to happen. I'll just death ray it so I can get these guys down to help with the big unit over here. I'm going to pull the swordsman, or no, what I really need to do is pull the reanimators back and have them heal themselves. As long as I can get the Storm Sisters close enough to hit that thing, I should be able to surround it with shock troopers. Maybe even kill it with shock troopers on this turn. Probably not, though. It might be better to leave them on defense so they take a little less damage from the broadside that I'm assuming it's going to fire off. And because why not? We'll shoot it with some archers. I'm gonna back up these guys so that they don't get caught in that broadside or shot by the Draconian Elder, which would be a pain. Just gonna get them kind of away from everything. And I'll put, like I said, put all my orcs on defense. Oh, he really wanted to kill that archer. That's fine too, I guess. Not the chickens. Alright, their heroes left himself vulnerable. And I do want to try to revive that archer if I can get over to it, which I think I just barely can. Okay, more experience for the Shock Sister. And let me try to pick him back up. Can't quite get there on this turn, so if I can keep the battle going for one more turn without losing any units, that would be ideal. I'm hoping to get to allow the Storm Sisters to get the kill on their hero out here. If I can get it to low enough health, it probably won't move because the Griffin Rider has first strike. Though I don't know if I'm going to be able to get it to quite low enough health. The Shock Trooper could get out there and lower its health a bit more. Alright, and then these other two will just go after this guy. No, you can die. Okay, he's got killing momentum, so he can move a little more. And I'll just keep him back. There's no sense in risking the swordsman. It's not going to have any major role to play in this battle. Now I'm hoping that this guy just defends, but he probably will attack this. Oh, he had Assassin Strike. Okay, well that's fine with me. That lets me revive the... Oh, one more space. Revive my longbow over here. Now, because I have all these Storm Sisters and they all have healing and that can get them XP, I need to have them heal any units that are damaged. Anything that they can get to. So, like, these guys could heal the longbow. This group could heal the Griffin Rider. I have another one over here that could heal the... Could heal this... That guy. Okay, that's good. I think I only had four in this battle. Where's the other one? Oh, they're down here. They could heal the longbowman or the swordsman. Doesn't really matter which. Probably the swordsman. He's a bit lower on health. And that's just that much extra XP for them. I'll let the archers and the shock troopers finish this thing off. Maybe the Griffin Rider. Look at who needs XP. I think the Shock Troopers probably need it more than anybody else, so I'll just give it to them. Okay, good battle. Didn't lose anybody and got some much-needed XP for some of my Storm Sisters. They should all be fairly close to getting to the next rank. In fact, all four of them are pretty close. This one's a bit further away. So that's helpful. Plus, drop some items. So I can see what sort of good stuff I get to pick up. He actually had some decent... he had some really good stuff. What is that? Inflict severely poisoned, inflict bleeding wounds, backstab, assassin strike, melee strength. This is going to my king. You got more of these books that give high morale. I should probably give one to each of my heroes. So, one to the Frostling. One to my king. And I don't know who else. Oh, you know, the other army that I had. I bet this might have been part of the army that killed my other group of units, actually, because I recognize some of these items. Huh. That's interesting. My king could use that shield. It's a lot better than this rusty disc of defense. Let's see who else I could give this to. Everyone's already got decent shield equipment, except for maybe my Tigran Druid, so I'll send that off to the Druid. And that means I can send this book to my king. Probably send this book to the Druid or the Rogue. I'll say the Druid, it can get there in one turn. These give fire protection. That's a pretty easy choice to send to my Frostling. A picnic basket. Need this to go to somebody who needs more healing in their group. Honestly, probably doesn't matter, but I'll give it to the Frostling because she probably has more space to hold things. The Lightning Wand needs to go to the Druid because he's probably more likely to fight some machines here soon since he's leading that army underground. That shield should go to my king, but my king's items are full, so I probably need to get rid of a couple of them. Yeah, like this Warhammer that gives Guardbreaker. I could give that to somebody else or get rid of it entirely. It's just plus one melee strength. Bloodthirsty. Wouldn't mind having Guardbreaker on the Rogue. So I'll probably give it to her. I know it would. I could technically like move him over there and have her pick it up or whatever, but not gonna mess around with all that. She'll just get it on the next turn, and it'll give me the prompt to put it into her inventory. I do want my king to keep the gun. The med bag sword will go on him. Some of those other items will get equipped on him, so he should be okay there. A lot of items in this group. Crossbow could go to the Rogue to give her a more powerful single shot hit. Chicken to also the Rogue, defending the wall. I'm honestly probably gonna have to get rid of some of this stuff. Black bolts go to the Druid because I kind of just feel like it. Everybody's getting full on items. This bronze-plated armor, I don't particularly care for that. Dreaded monkey mask. That might not be a bad thing for my king to have. Oh gosh, but everybody's full on items. I may just send another unit out here later to pick up the remainders. But right now, I think I just need everything to go to somebody. Alright. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. I might leave these groups kind of split up as they currently are. Maybe a slight change. Give that army one more Storm Sister. But these two armies are reasonably powerful armies in and of themselves. I kind of like that setup. I'm going to leave this elf out here on that item rack so that he can help organize some of that on the next turn. And I'll send these armies back towards the underground. Probably have this one hang out or at least move back in that direction too. Whenever it can move again anyway. Probably shouldn't have split them up. Oh, this is my new city underground. I was looking at this for a second, like, what is this? Builder's Hall. Let's try to get some production going. Pretty easy decision. I'm going to send them one more space this way so I can see the rest of the land there. As you can see, I'm not spawning any places that spawn monsters. So I'll have them run down this direction. They're dwarves, so they can handle these mountains a little better than most races. There is some scrolls of knowledge out here that I wouldn't mind grabbing while I'm in the area. Okay, before building the fort there, I'm going to build a tower out a little further down this road with this builder on the next turn, probably as far as I can get it to go.
We've got a couple issues we need to figure out how to handle.
Okay. What are we looking at?
Well, first of all, did you see Orange's army coming up towards your underground city? You see what they've got there?
Oh, gosh. No, I didn't see them, so thanks for pointing that out. Three juggernauts, dang. Well... how many turns do you think it would take them to get there? This is telling me they could be here in two turns. That makes me think I need to split up these armies that are on the surface and get units down there as fast as possible. What's the other issue before I retreat all of my units to the underground?
The other issue is Brown's going after Anthoria. And I'm wondering if there's a way we could defend it with our units, or if I'd be better off retreating and then going back to retake it. Because all of our units could get there at the beginning of the next turn. I'm just not sure if we could arrange them in a way that could actually defend against 8 Manticore Riders.
We'd have to be really fast. Well, I would probably send my king's army over there. So, and then I'm assuming you would bring up some of your units from Engranost?
No. Well, I could, but there's nowhere to put them.
Where are you going to be? Oh, you're going to be bringing your king's main army stacked down.
I could bring four of those units from Engranost. That'd just be one more thing we had to do.
But what if the Manticore Riders turned and went after Engranost? Actually, it doesn't look like they could quite reach it.
If they did that, we could probably just pick them off out in the field.
Well, actually, this group over here could reach it. Well, no, they wouldn't be able to, because they could reach where my King's Army currently is, but my King's Army is theoretically going to be gone. I think that the best solution, the best option is for me to bring my king's army over, put them on the tile southwest of the city very quickly at the next turn. If you want to bring, I think you should leave your units in Engranost, and I'll leave my other army there. That way we've got some force there, and use your main king's army to help defend Anthoria. You could maybe even just... oh, actually, you really do want that phalanx in this battle. Will you be able to arrange all those units quickly enough, though? And move them around.
Do it right now.
Oh, right, they all have movement. So, yeah, I think that you should put your king's... You plan on having your king's army help defend Anthoria, and then arrange the rest of those units however you want. And then I'll bring up my king's army and put him in the space southwest of the city. So you should take the center space and the space west of center.
Okay.
And I'll just move my king's army now. Since they're all elves, I can cut through that forest without any issues. Because I do have to run around. Okay. With that in mind, I'm going to send this other group of men that I have here just kind of randomly. I'll send them south to kind of help with Engranost in case something shows up, since they won't really do any good. The most units you can get into a battle defensively is usually three, unless the computer is really stupid about how they decide to attack you. But... I think with my king stack up there and then three stacks down here, we should be okay in both locations, and none of those Manticore Riders can reach Engranost to surprise attack us. Alright, how do I want to split up the rest of my army, though? That's a good question. Obviously, I want any Storm Sisters that can get down there to get there as soon as they can. And really any units that I can get down there. Can get their Griffin Rider a couple spaces closer. Just kind of splitting everyone up right now, but that's fine. There aren't any Dreadnought units in this area at the moment. Wouldn't mind getting a couple Shock Troopers out here to the center of the map, so I will take these guys and run them west. They should be able to join my other armies within a couple turns at Engranost. The Reanimator, don't know what I want him to do. My king has one in his army. And there's one in this group. So I might send this third Reanimator down to the underground to help keep my other units alive while they fight the Dreadnoughts. And the Archer too. Alright. If the Dreadnought decides to attack, my Tigran City underground should be able to hold it. Alright, I don't have enough casting points to do anything else with this Lost Soul on this turn, so the best I can do with it is just kind of float around down here and be a nuisance. Okay. And that is the end of my turn. So we will see what happens on the next one. This could get interesting. I'm assuming you're going to pull away the other units that are by the shoreline to keep the Manticore Riders
Love it if the Manticore Riders attacked those, because that would give me a chance for my ships to just bomb away at them for a turn.
That's true, the battle would be taking place on the water.
Yeah, I don't have any swimming or flying units.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. I don't know, because with the city being right there, normally if they attack the tile right next to that city, it would be a city battle. I don't know, do you think it'd be...
But... Not going to be a city battle.
Okay. Alright, well, if that all works, then hopefully we should be okay on the next turn, but we're at an hour and a half here, so I do need to wrap this one up. I feel a little better at the end of this episode than I did at the end of the last one, just because it seems like we are holding this main line. We don't have a lot of territory, unfortunately, and expanding has kind of not really been an option for me because I've been spending all my money, but... There are structures out here that once my dwarves have cleared this area a little more, I might try to put a couple cities out here, or forts or something, just to generate resources. Might be more likely forts, because I can build builders faster. And then I guess, other than that, it's just a matter of holding the front line. Evan was able to kill quite a few goblin units, different stragglers and things around here, and is beginning to realize just how good exalteds are. Kind of chasing these things down. So if we can continue to do that, and if we can hold off Brown's Manticore Riders, in fact, if we can kill 8 of their Manticore Riders right here, that would really help a lot. Even so, that's going to be a tough city defense battle, but with both of our kings in the battle, I think we should fare a little better. Alright everyone, that pretty much sums it up for now, so thank you very much for watching. Always be sure to check out Evan's channel to get his post commentary on the game. Helps him out. Like and subscribe to his as well if you could. And we will see you in episode, 13, I think.